Alright guys, welcome to the video. You can see right in front of us there. We are here for Hollow Scream here in Busch Gardens, Tampa. 20 years of fear. This is the Hell on Wheels Scare Zone. That's why there's a little sign here. I thought it was kind of a weird intro there. But we are over here by Iron Gwazi. That's the only reason I'm starting here. I just want to give you a little look at some of the stuff going on here for Iron Gwazi. They used to have a little banner right here, but the banner's kind of gone now, so don't know what's up with that. But regardless, I'm going to show you a little bit here as much as I can. So let me do some B-roll type stuff, and then we'll probably get into Hollow Scream. So I might talk a little bit after this clips, but as of right now, let's show you a little bit of the track work. Alright, so you guys can see right in front of us here, this is the twist that's going to go into the lift hill, or through the lift hill I should say. You can see they actually are working on the track there. You can see the track actually is being put onto the structure, not the train. But anyways, that gives you kind of a good look at what they're working on. So yeah, you can see the hill is just a little bit taller, but it gives you a good idea of what they're doing there. So it's gonna be a pretty big beast, I think. So pretty cool. So yeah guys, that's a little bit of a look there at Iron Gwazi. Like I said, I'm not 100% sure why they're going with the gator theme. I mean, gator and Gwazi, I don't think it has anything to do with each other. I've kind of looked it up, so I don't know. I think it would have been cooler if they would have just had a combination and made the track green. That would have been a really cool thing, a cool nod to the old Gwazi. But anyways, the alligator does look pretty cool, and the trains look pretty awesome too. I ain't gonna lie, the trains look really great. But yeah, I just wanted to give you a little look here, just show you a little bit of the construction. Check out you know, some of the other people's some of the other vloggers' footage or whatever. They might have some better footage and stuff. But yeah, pretty cool. Just wanted to give you a little look, and yeah, we're going to be doing Hollow Scream tonight, so the next thing probably going to show you all is Hollow Scream. And yeah, that'll be about it. So, I'll see you guys when Hollow Scream gets started. Alright guys, so our first house of the night was Insomnia. They really stepped their game up on this one this year. I actually really enjoyed that. A lot of very good production value going on in there. They really did some really high quality stuff, and I commend them highly for it. So, first house of the night is turning out pretty good. Let's hope it keeps going that way for the next couple of houses. I think the next one is the Reverence or whatever, the new one that they're having this year. So, we're going to check that one out. But, yep, Insomnia was a good start. So, let's keep going, and we'll see what other whatever mischief and mayhem we can get into. All right, guys. So, we made our way back to the front a little bit. We're going to do the Dia de los Muertos, which is Day of the Dead, I believe. But I don't think this guy's actually part of it, but he's looking pretty creepy. Pretty cool, but let's get into this scare zone, and then we'll head over to the toy scare zone. So let's check it out. Thank you. Alright guys, so we're heading into Carpe Noctem. I think it's like a vampire thing, so let's check it out. Alright guys, we're headed into Pantopia now, and it's actually been transformed into Maniac Midway for the Halloween Hollow Scream event. So let's check it out before we check out the Revenants. I think it's the new house. So let's check out some of the Maniac Midway a little bit. Bravo!
Oh! Hey, we have a job opening for a bearded lady. You want it?
Sure do. Alright guys, so this house is the Residence, not the Revenants, the Residence. So this is the new house for the year. You guys know I don't record in houses, I don't really believe in that. But anyways, we're all gonna do the Residence and I'll tell you what I think about it on the way out. I did want to mention, I would probably give Insomnia an 8 out of 10. So I'll give you guys a little rating on all six of the houses here. But yeah, you can see that we're using the little frontline pass, so I'll tell you about that. I'll kind of review that at the end of the night as well. But as of right now, let's check out the Residence. All right guys, just came out of the Residence. Wow, y'all, like, they're really stepping up their game this year on the production value. Like, they're really, everything was super high quality. The scares were great. They're really doing some fantastic work this year. So the Residence is a very, very awesome addition to the park. We're very glad to see that. Awesome. That was an excellent, excellent house. So pretty cool. It was kind of like a kind of your standard story about, like, you know, just crazy people living in a house, but it was very well done. The sets were beautiful and everything was fantastic. So let's keep walking through the Maniac Midway here. Oh no, I'm getting yelled at already. Oh no, this guy's got hugs, man. Can I give you a hug? I'm gonna give you a hug. Good hug, good hug, thank you. Got a free hug from a bear. Best scare zone, 10 out of 10. No need to say no more. Anyways, guys, like I said, Residence, though, excellent, excellent house. That house was fantastic. But we're going to move on. And yeah, looking forward to the rest of the event. I hope it's hope the quality holds up, because they're setting the bar a little high now. They better watch out. So let's keep going, and we'll see what else to say. As far as a rating, 9 out of 10, easy. Oh, look out. I'm getting jump scared from left and right. But, yeah, 9 out of 10, easy. That was a great house. That was a good one.
Taking a picture, can it last longer?
Yeah.
You're making an eye contact with this? You gotta look at that magic box.
Magic box, man.
Yeah, have fun. But now you guys, know if you go in there, you're gonna turn like out like us.
Hey, that'd be good with me.
You're not gonna make it out alive.
That'd be cool with me, man. I was gonna say, we're headed into Camp DOA, guys. Let's check it out. Low to the ground action. I think I'm too late. All right. I don't know what it is, guys, but they're stepping up some quality game this year. Like, things are a little bit higher quality. But yeah, that's Camp DOA, pretty cool scare zone there. They're doing a lot of focusing on their scare zones this year, which is cool. Uh-oh.
You're never gonna leave there, boy.
Oh man, that's fun. Pretty cool, guys. Like I said, they're stepping their quality up, man. Stepping the quality. But we're gonna keep walking here. That was Camp DOA. And yeah, a lot of fun, y'all. A lot of fun. Let's keep seeing what we can see. All right, guys, so we're headed into the black spot. This has been a favorite of mine the past few years with the pirate theme. I like my pirates. But let's head in, see what they got for us this year. And then I'll give you guys a rating on the way out. They're setting the bar pretty high with these past two houses. Let's keep it going high with this one. All right, guys, just got out of the black spot. Not as good as the last two houses, but definitely improved from last year. So they are stepping their game up in that field, which is awesome. My non-biased opinion, 6 out of 10. My biased opinion, 9 out of 10. There's the review. But anyways, you guys know I like my pirate theming, so. Anyways, like I said, though, for real, it's probably about a 7 out of 10 non-bias. And then my bias, yeah, I love it. I think it's great. So, anyways, pretty cool. Just wanted to mention we got out of Black Spot, but we're going to head over. And I think they have a new scare zone over by Sesame Street. So I want to find out what the name of that is, and then we'll go record it so you guys can see what's up. All right, guys, so this is Little Nightmares. This is a new zone here this year. So let's check it out, see what they got to offer.
Stop.
Alright guys, we're headed into Motel Hell. You know the drill, I'm gonna go through it, give you a little rating afterwards. We'll see what it's like. This has been our favorite house in the past 2 years. This is a whole Motel Hell infestation. So we'll see what they can do this year. And let's hope it's good. Alright guys, good news for Motel Hell. They did not mess it up. Fantastic still. Some of the best effects in any of the houses. The sets are beautiful. Basically just Motel Hell with a bunch of roaches and mice. Nothing wrong with that. Pretty darn good. Still awesome. At Residence though, I think the Residence might be equal to it, man. Residence was good. So very high quality, man. I'm so impressed so far. But we're going into Simon's Slaughterhouse, and I think Slaughterhouse are the weakest haunted houses there are. Just my personal opinion. But we're gonna head through the meat market here, and then we'll head to Simon's Slaughterhouse, and I'll tell you how it is when we get out. Alright guys, let's head into Simon's Slaughterhouse, and then I'll see you at the exit. Alright guys, so just got out of Simon's Slaughterhouse. Actually improved this year. Still a slaughterhouse, not super big fan of slaughterhouses, but Simon's Slaughterhouse was actually pretty decent this year. But yep, pretty cool. This guy's having some breathing problems over here.
Drink from your skull, worm!
I think he's hungry. What do you guys think? But anyways, I'm not a big Slaughterhouse fan. I'm a fan of that dude. That dude's cool. But anyways, Slaughterhouse, 6 out of 10. Pretty average. I forgot to say Motel Hell, 8 out of 10. Easy. So pretty cool. But I like this guy. This guy's a good character. He's here every year in the meat house. Or the meat market. So, they do a fantastic job. Very awesome. Alright, let's keep going. And we'll go over to the Deathwater Bayou. And then we're also going to hit up the Hell on Wheels Scare Zone. Alright guys, so we're going to go through the Hell on Wheels Scare Zone. I'm going to try to get this tall dude on camera here. He does pretty awesome.
Seems like a safe distance or location may not be. Unless told to evacuate, avoid roads to allow emergency vehicles access. Please stand by for an action message from your local authorities.
Yeah. Alright guys, so we're headed into Deathwater Bayou. You know the drill. Gonna go through it, give you the review afterwards. And this will actually be the last thing. We've went through everything, so let's make it a good one here. Alright guys, that's gonna do it here. Deathwater Bayou was really good this year. They're just stepping up their quality, man. And I'll talk about that a little bit more in the outro, but yeah, definitely a 7 out of 10. Very strong house. Really enjoyed it. So yeah, got a lot to say about this event this year. Saving it for the outro though, we're gonna head over to the gift shop. I wanna show you guys the little shop of horrors or whatever they call it. We're gonna show you that, the little Hollow Scream gift shop. And then after that, we'll call it a video with the outro and that'll be it. So pretty cool. And I'll talk about all that here in a minute. All right guys, so this is the shop. Not gonna say too much, just wanna give you little pointers and can't give you an idea what they got going on here. So this is the event shirt here. You can see this is the back of it. You can see they got Black Spot, The Residence. They got Insomnia, Slaughterhouse, Deathwater Bayou, and Motel Hell. So this is the event shirt. Pretty nice shirt. Definitely going to be picking that one up. And as far as price goes, let's see if we can get a little bit of action here. It is $24.99. So, pretty cool. They do have little light up Hollow Scream hats too, which is neat. Little blankets. Now this is the 20 Years of Fear shirt. It's got a bunch of different years on here. You can see like 2012, 2013, but you can see it's got all the years on there listed eventually. So pretty cool that. Pretty cool that, yeah, that makes a lot of sense, but it's pretty cool there. So I was trying to say, I like it. See how much this is. That one is $26.99. You can see the price tag there. I do like that shirt. That's a nice one as well. Let's walk in here, check out some of the decor in the shop.
Brianna, did you rent some back? Never mind.
Pretty cool little shop here. I do like this every year. They do have a nice little gift shop. All kinds of little trinkets and different horror related things. Pretty cool. I do like that they have this red Hollow Scream shirt to choose from this year. It's pretty cool. Like that a lot. A little electric chair over here. Pretty neat. The Widowmaker. I like it. That's cool. Now, this is one thing I think is a little disappointing this year is they don't actually have an event pin. They just kind of have these little, like, smaller pins. And then here's the real disappointing thing. They got mystery boxes, guys. Like, and they're cool. Like, don't get me wrong. Like, they're cool, like, pins. But I'm not into mystery boxes, so won't be picking any of these up. But, yeah, you can see they got, like, all the little houses. Then they also have ones from different years here. You can see they got Evil Encore and Unearthed, Cursed. So it's kind of like the theming throughout the years. Not happy with that though. Not happy with that much at all. Especially with, I think you get two pins for $25 there. If it'll focus. So, not too stoked about that one. The event lanyard looks pretty cool this year though. I like it. But anyways, just wanted to give you a little tour. So, gonna go find a good place to do the outro, and then we will call it a video. All right, guys. So it's a little bit loud here, but I wanted to do it. I want to show you these projections. That is gonna do it here from Hollow Scream 2019. 20 Years of Fear. It's pretty cool. But yeah, we did the Frontline Fear for $40, which was pretty decent. $40 a piece, that is. So it was $84 altogether. So not too bad. especially for, you know, we got past all the lines. Everything was great as far as that goes. But guys, for real, they've stepped up the quality this year. It is spectacular. Now, I do want to take it with a grain of salt, though, because it is media night tonight. So keep that in mind. We did come on media night. So they might be really kind of hamming it up a little bit. Not sure. But the besides that, though, the quality of the sets, the set, like I said, the set design, the production value is so much higher than the previous years. So kudos to Busch Gardens for keeping Hollow Scream pretty cool, but they've made it even better this year. And I wanted to commend them for that. They did a great job. We enjoyed it. I'll give the event a 7 out of 10. Very solid event overall. And the best three houses were definitely The Residence, Motel Hell, and Insomnia. Those three houses are fantastic. Like I said, they really stepped up their game this year. Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. And as always, you can follow me on my Instagram at Daily Theme Park Photos. You can also follow me on Twitter at Corey Mathery, same as my YouTube channel name. And you can also follow me on TikTok at Corey Says Yo, if you're so inclined. Anyways, guys, that is going to do it here from Hollow Scream 20, 20 years of fear. This has been a really good event, and I'm glad that we finally had a really solid quality year from Hollow Scream. I think they were kind of falling off last year, and they redeemed themselves this year. So, anyways, really cool. I hope you're enjoying these projections as I've been talking, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching. Have a fantastic evening. Happy Halloween. All right, guys, real quick, just want to do a little bonus here on the end of the video. I did want to mention, if you get the little, you know, the front line of fear or whatever, either be Ultimate or the just the regular for the houses. The Ultimate comes with the coasters and the houses. We just got the regular because we rode all the coasters today, except for Cheetah Hunt, but we were worried about it. I was trying to do my POVs today, which check those out on my channel if you're interested. But anyways, just wanted to mention, you do get 20% off merchandise items throughout the night, and you also get, if you buy a $40 game pass, you can get it for $20. So just wanted to make sure that I mentioned that. So pretty cool. So anyways, guys, just wanted to mention the 20% and the games pass. All right, guys, take care.